Holics Network 18, Mission Poshan, Bhavishya Roshan.
A very good morning. Welcome to Chartbusters. Well, this is a show where we'll highlight all the buzzing stocks yet another day, yet another day. The markets are in the red, the real pressure in the mid-cap index. We have some economic data as well that's coming in there. The India May Nikkei Composite PMI, that's coming at around 50.4. That's a bit of a contraction if you look at it on a month-on-month basis. So keep an eye out on that data. But the real story really is in the markets today. In fact, we have seen selling on the frontline index. The mid-cap index, that's the pressure point. At least the Nifty Bank is a relative outperformer, actually. Absolutely. At least the last time I checked were there. But plenty of stocks on the BSE itself, more than 200 stocks are at lower circuit, Mangalam.
Well, six stocks in the red for one in the green. Oh. Yesterday, we spoke about those crisscross lines, crossing each other. But today, they haven't spoken to each other at all. Right from the day word go, we had the red line above the green line. What's interesting is that yesterday, we broke below the 20-day moving average, which was 10,665. And the next moving average, so to say, comes in at 100 days, which is 10,550. Below that is the 50-day moving average, 10,530. 200-day moving average is 10,358. Guess where the maximum put interest is? Yeah. At 10,200. So basically, the maximum open interest support comes in at 10,200. All the moving averages are ahead of that, above that. So let's see where we go from here.
Absolutely, Mangalam. And all the stock of auditors, ASM, every now and then we're hearing that. That's not really helping any of these mid-cap stocks as well. So you look at the headline index, you'll say, well, we're down only around 5% from the peak. And you look at the mid-cap and the small-cap space, well, in fact, the index is down between 16 to around 22%. But if you look at individual stocks, they have lost 50% of their market capitalization as well. So it's not looking very, very good. But let's find out, how do you trade the Nifty from here? And do you trade the Nifty from here? Ashwani joins us. Ashwani, you're still looking at shorting this index, even at these levels. And what's the point you're looking at when, in fact, you believe that those shorts should be closed out?
See, mid-caps by their very nature is gas in and gas out. So if you buy stuff at, you know, when it's gone up 10 times, this is what you will suffer. So mid-cap suffering is likely to continue. Obviously, with all of these regulations, etc., the suffering will worsen. But just from a very two-day type perspective, you are at 10:30 and already, you know, the advances are 230 and decliners are 1400. Now, how much worse can you beat up something? So my sense is that this is a good time to cover intraday shorts and take long positions. I think to, you know, kill this market further, you possibly need some sort of a intraday rally for any reason or for no reason to happen before you get volume to short into. If stocks are falling vertically, I mean, you can't take fresh short positions. So my sense is, particularly on the Bank Nifty, 1,000 points yesterday, 5070 today, I think at some point financials will shake up the shorts a little bit, but it'll only be a shake up. I think the market is clearly in a bearish zone, and that bearish zone will probably get to the lower end of the range, which is about 10,000. We are 10,000, 11,000. We shouldn't be looking at any fancy targets for this year. Having said that, because I am positioned on the long side, you know, I would like to give some long ideas, because if the market turns, you make money. Otherwise, you are losing anyway. So keep a stop on the Bank Nifty. Interesting thing, intraday low has not been violated on the futures. Similarly, on the Nifty, intraday low not been violated. So my sense is, this is where, you know, shorts sometimes get trapped. So Motherson is a buy with a stop of 308, target of 324. TVS Motor is a buy with a stop of 565, target of 580. And Bajaj Finance is a buy with a stop of 2060, target of 2120. Today's low is a stop. If we start to break that, then all these calls are off. But my sense is that this sort of selling pressure cannot sustain, you know, once early morning everybody is on the same side.
Ashwani, two questions before we let you go. The first one is on the Nifty. You said you are suggesting an intraday long on the Nifty. So what is the target and the stop loss for that, as well as the Nifty Bank? Secondly, individual stocks, both HDFC Bank and Indiabulls Housing Finance. Indiabulls Housing Finance more so, it's down close to around 10% this month itself. Do you think there's more to go, especially given the fact that you say there would be some reversal in the financial space?
See, with rate hikes coming, NBFCs will get hammered, mm-hmm. but it's fallen 10% in 3 days, maybe right. some amount of pullback. The pullbacks happen only in quality stocks. Hmm. So all stocks will not pull back. In terms of Nifty target, you know, 10,640, 650, that sort of zone if we get, you know, particularly Reliance is, you know, fighting for the bulls. At some point, it may actually be successful. And also on the Bank Nifty target, maybe 26,400 thereabouts, because in terms of stop, the day's low is a fairly close stop. So that way the risk is low. And, you know, once short covering, etc. picks up, generally you tend to get quite a bit of upside.
Okay, all right. Thanks so much for that, Ashwani. Well, we'll keep touching base with you all through the trading session. Well, keep an eye out on the index. Breadth of the market isn't great. Some of these stocks that have had a good run, Z Entertainment, that stock's moved to the low point of the day, so keep an eye out on that. But otherwise, in fact, at least you have the likes of HDFC as well as SBI. They are trying to bat for the bulls as we speak. But a lot of stocks are falling. One such stock is KEI Industries. Now, that stock is down nearly around 10% in today's trading session. So we'll slip into a short break. You come back, we'll get chatting with the management.
The unrest in the mid-cap space continues. The advance decline ratio has widened further. Seven stocks in the red for one in the green, as against six just when we started out the show. So we'll keep an eye out on this. One such mid-cap which is under pressure is KEI Industries. Swiftly lost about 17% at one point in time in today's trading session. Now recovered a bit from the lows, but still down about 10%. So what exactly could have happened in today's move? What perhaps caused that panic? Well, we have Anil Gupta, the chairman and managing director of KEI Industries, joining us on the phone line. Mr. Gupta, there was a bit of panic selling on your stock this morning, down about 17%. Any change in the business that may have suggested this, or maybe promoters selling some stakes, some pledge which has been offloaded in the market, anything that you can explain to us?
There is absolutely no change in our business. Mm-hmm. Business is absolutely intact. There is no trigger, there is no adverse event, there is no adverse news. In fact, our order book is growing. We are L1 in around another 700 crore worth of EPC orders, which are likely to be finalized in next 1 month. Our order book is strong, and we, as promised, we expect to give 20% growth in our top line. We are as per the guidance. So far, we have not sold any stock of ours, nor pledged anybody anything, nor our key executives have sold anything.
Okay, all right. So, Mr. Gupta, what you're clarifying to us here on CNBC TV18 is that there is no change in the business. You are sticking to your guidance of 20%, and promoters, they have not sold. Correct?
Yes.
There is no Absolutely. Pledge on the promoters holding as well.
We have never pledged any shareholding okay. at any point of time in our life.
All right. You know, Mr. Gupta, we need to clarify these issues because there are a whole host of, you know, companies that are under pressure. So let's start off with: is there any auditor issue?
No, not at all. No auditor.
You all had changed your auditor maybe around a year and a half ago or something, but that was there was no big reason that you all changed it, right?
Our published balance sheet yes. is out, audited balance sheet is out, and it is in the public view.
Okay, all right. So there is no problem with the auditor. I didn't find your name in the ASM list. And also you're saying there is no issue with the promoters as of now. Correct, sir?
Yes.
All right, so we've got those points down, Mangalam.
All right, so let's get in some other details as well. Mr. Gupta, what is the debt on your books, including working capital, some trade payables, and when was the last payment due? Have you missed on any installments or something of that sort?
No, not at all. Our total debt actually is almost same on March 2018 as it was on March 2017.
How much is it?
Although we grew by... It was 780 crore and we grew by 28%. It remained same after 1 year with a growth of 28% in our sales and profits by almost 40-50%. And, all the payments are paid before due date. You know, So there is no issue of any payment.
So no outstanding payment, or rather no payment whatsoever is outstanding right now, right?
No, neither to any bank nor to any creditor.
All right. You know, Mr. Gupta, I think the street is hearing you. Remember, the markets have been very, very volatile. But at least for the time being, the street has taken note of what you're saying. The stock has recovered, I think, from the low point of the day by nearly around 8 to around 9% odd. So let's get a few details, sir. You're talking about a growth of around 20%. I remember a few months back, you were talking about a retail business and you're expecting it to grow to around 35 to around 40%. What does it constitute to, as of FY18? And in FY19, how do you see that scaling up?
In FY18, we registered a growth of around 30% in our retail business, and it constituted around 32 or 33% of our total turnover.
Okay.
And our aim is to grow it to around 40% in next 1 to 2 years, and we hope that we will be able to grow by 35% in our retail business this year as well.
All right. Mr. Gupta, you know, one of your facilities in Rajasthan was supposed to be commissioned in May 2018. We're in June right now. Has that facility been commissioned or has there been any delay or something of that sort?
It is partially commissioned. And, I think first phase will be fully operationalized by next 30 to 45 days.
And how much will this capacity add to your revenue in FY19?
It will add at approximately 25 crore rupees a month. Effective July or August, because it will take some 2 months to stabilize to reach the full capacity level.
And working capital days, sir, what is it at?
Working capital?
Yes. I remember, sir, your working capital days used to be around 110 odd. You had reduced it to around 100. As of last year, what was it?
It was around 95 days.
All right, Mr. Gupta, thanks so much for stopping by, giving us that clarity. I'm sure your investors were a worried lot. So you're clarifying no change in the business. The growth stands. It's likely to go up by nearly around 20% odd. And there's absolutely no delay in payments and the likes. Mangalam, you got some news coming in on HUL?
Absolutely. So the company has basically made an accounting change in their business. They've announced the integration of foods and refreshment categories. Foods is what has Kisan, Knorr, as well as the other food things that HUL makes. The refreshment categories are tea, coffee, as well as ice cream. So what they will basically do is they will combine both these categories and report in their numbers. Food and refreshment constitutes about 20% of the company's revenue as well as the earnings before interest and tax. So this is just an announcement, accounting adjustment. No real business change as far as HUL is concerned. So that is just something that analysts will keep an eye out on. See both these verticals merge and report their numbers together.
Okay, all right. On that note, we'll slip into a short break. On the other side, we'll focus on some macros. Markets have moved to the low point of the day. We're sitting with a cut of more than 50 points odd. But let's focus on some macro data we just got in. Now, India Services PMI, that's down for the first time in the past 3 months. To discuss this, we have Aditi Nair, principal economist at ICRA, who joins us on the phone line. Hi, Aditi. Thanks so much for joining in. What are you making of this services data? It looks quite disappointing. Does it replicate what's going on in the labor market? And how would you read it, basically?
Thanks. Good morning. Certainly the number isn't encouraging when we look at it in terms of the number coming in below 50 and indicating a contraction. That's certainly not an encouraging thing to start with. But if we look at the pattern which has been kind of established over the last several months, for the services PMI, we have repeatedly got this trend where we get a couple of months of a small contraction followed by 1 month of a dip. So it's not entirely out of line with what we've been seeing over the last 3 to 4 quarters, that we have a temporary dip and then immediately after that, the next month, it goes back into expansionary mode. And also, when we look at the extent to which it's below 50, actually, it's just marginally below 50 at 49.6. We've seen deeper troughs coming in the last few quarters.
Right.
So I'm not terribly disappointed, but certainly it's not something which is a very encouraging number either. And I think some of the other comments which are coming in terms of the input price pressures as well as the hiring are also not very encouraging.
Fair point there, Aditi. Not terribly disappointing as far as this number is concerned. And like you said, it has been lumpy in the past as well. So on the basis of all these things, do your forecasts for GDP growth change? What do they stand at right now? And how do you look at this, especially given the lumpiness and higher input costs that you spoke about? That, and before we let you go, your view on the RBI policy tomorrow.
So definitely in terms of our evolving forecast for this quarter, a couple of things which are going to be important are to what extent crude oil prices start eating into margins. So we're not expecting there to be a further uptick in growth in Q1 relative to what we found in Q4, which were several quarter high numbers of 7.7% for GDP and 7.6% for GVA. We are expecting a slight slowdown between Q4 and Q1, partly because of the input price pressures coming in from commodity prices. Although as of now, our view is that volume growth is still going to remain high. For the year as a whole, we expect GDP and GVA growth to rebound from the lower levels in FY18 and consolidate at around 7%, 7.1% in FY19. For tomorrow, for the MPC, our view is that we're going to have a split vote with a hold and very hawkish commentary indicating that there'll be a rate hike in the offing.
Okay, all right, Aditi. Thanks so much. Pleasure talking to you as always. We'll keep an eye out on the RBI policy, but for the time being, keep an eye out on the markets. Now, the Nifty has moved to the low point of the day. We're down close to around 58 points as we speak, and a whole host of stocks are moving lower. Lupin has moved lower. HDFC Bank, one would have thought it would have been a dream stock yesterday. Yesterday it ended in the red. Today as well, it's come in for some selling pressure. Not looking too good, but we'll wrap up, Mangalam.
We will wrap up with just one thing. You know, we started the show saying six stocks in the red. Now that number has gone to eight stocks in the red as against one in the green. With that, it's a wrap on Chartbusters. But stay tuned to CNBC TV18. Trading Hour comes up next.